Hi, I'm James Blake, and you're watching MSN Exclusives. Suddenly I'm hidden, it's the darkness of the dawn, and your friends are gone, and your friends won't come, so show me where you fit, so show me where you fit. Thanks for coming to Canada.
Yeah, I mean, thanks for having us.
Oh, we loved it. Well, one of the first times I heard of you was through the Feist cover.
Yeah.
You loved Canada way back when.
I know. What and the Case of You cover.
And who?
And the Joni Mitchell cover.
Oh.
Yeah.
You do a Joni cover.
Yeah.
I don't know that strictly, one. I'm going to have to go dig that one up.
Strictly Canadian covers.
that's what you do in the show. Yeah. When you come to Canada, do you make sure to play those Strictly Canadian covers? Or is it just like, no, those are from back
then? Well, Limit, I was. I mean, Case of You always gets a nice reaction because it has the phrase "Oh Canada" in it, anyway, with a really elongated "Oh Canada," and like everyone, you know. Everyone
so you know how to get that. A pop out of the crowd. It's one of those "Hello people, Cleveland" moments.
People like that bit.
What was it about Feist music? What was it about that tune? Maybe you want to talk about the Joni one instead, since you brought that one up.
The Joni one is just a piano cover, but the Feist one really turned it on its head. So. It became more of like an interpolation, or I don't know. It's just different.
Hmm. And is it folk music that you gravitate to? I mean, they're both folky kind of tunes. Mm.
No, it was purely song based. It was like, you know, oh, I like that song. I'm gonna have a go at singing it. I didn't even think about releasing them until. I mean, in fact, the Joni Mitchell cover was just it was called a wild card track on a Radio 1 live thing that we did, and I didn't think it would be released, but we ended up liking the record. And,
There's always songs like that on. I mean, we'll talk about the new record here, Overgrown. There's always songs that you don't think are going to make it, that you don't. You're like, it's a throwaway, and then someone else says, no, that's the one. Mm-hmm. That one needs to go on. Were there any tunes on that? Yeah, so what on the new record was like that?
Some of my sort of most successful tunes have been things that I thought were to this or to that, and then people were kind of going, no, you got to release that.
Well, what off the new record that someone convinced you to release that you didn't think you were going to?
On this record, Voyeur. The sort of housey tune. I didn't know if it would fit on the record, but I mean, I think it does now. It gives you a little variation anyway. It's just, you know, not too much of the same thing.
You were talking about variation. You were talking about being able to vary the set list now that you can tour two records and have more that people know and that you can. So how have you managed to mold the new songs in with the old ones? They're a little different.
Yeah, they are. They're a bit more focused, these ones, I think. They come quite easily to me to sing, these ones, mostly because I've had a bit more practice writing as well, so I'm writing for my voice and singing for the songs that I write.
And you weren't doing that before?
I just think the synergy's got a lot tighter and more harmonious.
Is that happening as you continue to write? I assume you write all the time, I would think.
Yeah. Well, not so much now. I mean, I've just done an album, and I'm just you know, I was really empty by the end of that. So I'm kind of letting the batteries recharge, and hopefully, I mean, I've got the will to write, and I've been doing some beats and stuff like that. Some more beat based things.
Is that where things start, on the IP1 or in Logic or
OP1?
OP1.
Sometimes it just starts with a poem or a weird little sample or. I don't know. It's just comes from everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Hopefully it does anyway. I mean, that's the most interesting way to write for me. It's just it can come from anywhere.
Wait for the inspiration to hit.
Mm.
Speaking of mystery, we had Curly, she's an Estonian EDM singer on the show this morning.
Right.
I mentioned I was talking to you and I said, do you have any questions for James? And she was like, yeah, I love that record for sure.
Amazing.
Like,
oh.
So she goes, you have very deep music. Have you ever really been in love, and how many times have you gotten your heart broken? This is her asking you.
My heart has never been broken.
So how do you write such heartfelt songs?
I don't know.
Your heart has never been broken. You've never experienced that.
No.
You're a lucky man, let me tell you.
Yeah, or I'm on death row and I'm just waiting for the call.
The arrow, yeah.
No, I don't know. I mean, you know, we all have our own shit to talk about.
Sure, sure.
I mean, there was one, it's weird actually, there was one review, I think it was, that said something like, and I get sent these periodically, so that's why I know about this. It was kind of like, you know, I'm not convinced by where his, you know, what he's singing about, where his emotions coming from. What? I mean, you know, it's hard to believe that he could be sad about something, you know.
The man never gets sad.
Fuck.
That's amazing. I love reviewers for that reason. That's hilarious.
Well, I mean, you know, they're a source of much humor.
Justin Vernon, Kanye influenced the record. From what I've read, how so?
Not really.
Okay. Because I don't hear it. So I was like, how is that possible?
No, they didn't really. I mean, Justin influenced my first record to no end. Really, you know, I listened to Forever. I listened to Stax for most of the song off that record.
Is Kanye, because I heard so you love the Watch the Throne tour.
Yeah.
Has that influenced you as a performer? Oh, Radiohead influenced you as a performer?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
How do you, when you go to a show like that, what do you take that maybe you can bring to your live show?
Well, I think what was nice about the Watch the Throne tour was that the visuals, it wasn't overblown, even though it was a huge show. It was subtle. It was really, it was fairly avant-garde. It was interesting. Great use of animals. Or at least, you know, images of them. And kaleidoscopes and, you know, really basic imagery that just looked great. And it wasn't... And that kind of influenced the way we do the show, in the sense that we're simple. You know, we like to keep things simple, and I think we just want lights. We don't need much imagery or anything like that. We just want to have, you know, good lighting, good music, and a rapport with the crowd in it, you know, through the music. And I know, you know, that just for me, that's a good show. So Radiohead, similar thing. You know, they came and did the O2, and it was an incredible show. Not just for the fact that Radiohead are so good, but and their songs, is, you know, the back catalogue is immense. Just also the way they use lighting was really thoughtful, and you made great use of a big stage. Made you feel intimate, even though there were 20,000 people there. You know, it was really important show, I thought.
So we don't have too much time. We're going to do 5 questions how we end every interview, but I wore my Jimi Hendrix t-shirt because I hear Hendrix is influencing what you're working on lately.
Yes.
How so? Because I don't hear those fuzzbox guitars over.
Yeah, no, I think you'll hear... it's Band of Gypsies. It's the Band of Gypsies album. It's just, you know... And I remember...
So you play guitar too? Are you trying to?
I can. I'm not going to try.
You hire people to do that.
Yeah, I'm not going to try, and I'm not going to... you probably won't hear much guitar unless it's Rob. No, it's just an amazing album. It's the sound of the crowd, you know, the crowd participation, clapping, and like, I'm big into the noise of a crowd. That's been something that has really caught my eye recently, and one of the reasons I realized the other day that I enjoy gospel records so much, it's just another thing that makes me enjoy a gospel record, is the sound of the people in the church, or, you know, or even the kind of an unruly choir, you know, like sort of clapping in the background, you know, it's just great. Yeah. And Band of Gypsies has that in spades, you know. Buddy Miles is also my favorite drummer, so.
That helps, yeah.
Yeah.
5 quick questions, 1 word answers. Road or studio?
Studio.
Lennon or McCartney?
McCartney.
When you hear a song, what usually hits you first? Lyrics, melody, or rhythm?
Melody.
Song you've written you're most proud of?
Retrograde.
Cool. The single that worked out well that was chosen. In 1 word, James Blake.
James.
That's good. Thank you very much, man. I appreciate it.